All right, folks, my name is David Rush. Who's ready for some entertainment? This is the entertainment section of the show. Well, my life took a slight detour 3.5 years ago when I juggled for 6 minutes, 34 seconds, wearing a blindfold, breaking my very first Guinness World Records title. I did it to promote STEM education, science, technology, engineering, math. I'm passionate about it. You can see it's a tangible example that if you've set your mind to a goal, believe in yourself, and pursue it with a passion, you can accomplish virtually anything. You see, too many students grow up and they fail a math test, struggle at science, and are told by somebody, hey, you should focus on something else because you're not very good at this. Well, I've read a fair amount of research that suggests that this is simply not true. You see, when I was in second grade, I tried out for the gifted program. I took a test, and I failed. I didn't get in. I wasn't smart enough. Well, I tried out again in fifth grade, and I did get in, but only for math. Does that mean I couldn't be good at science or history or art or literature? Well, I kept working hard, and by the time I was finished with high school, I was offered admission into MIT, where I got my electrical engineering degree. And I tell you, it kicked my butt. But every time I was challenged, every time I failed, I used it as an opportunity to improve and learn. And who here has ever said, I don't remember names well? I've got two left feet, can't dance. I'm not a great leader. I'm not a good speaker. I get angry easily. Something's holding you back. Well, I'm here to tell you that if you approach life with a growth mindset, this idea that you can get better at anything, you really can. All of these things can be learned and developed and improved upon, and I break Guinness World Records as an example of that. So what happens when you approach life with a growth mindset and grit? Well, today, I'm going to attempt to break my 100th Guinness World Record. In fact, more accurately, it is my 98th, 99th, and 100th Guinness World Record today. Now, some of them are many of them are silly or esoteric, like I have the fastest mile run balancing a raw egg on a spoon in my mouth. 8 minutes and 2 seconds. Sure, it was difficult, but not very many people try. But there are some records I'm really, really excited about and proud of. Like, I have the record for most consecutive axe juggling catches. 3 3-pound axes juggled 839 times before I finally fatigued and dropped one. I have the record for longest duration balancing a ladder on my chin. The most bowling balls juggled. It's 3. I've now juggled blindfolded for more than 22 minutes. And then there was that holy grail record, that one I didn't think I'd ever be able to break, which was the most juggling catches in 1 minute. If I broke that one, I could become the fastest juggler in the world. But I didn't think I could break it. And I'd been juggling for a long time, so I practiced, and I got my baseline. I was like, okay, this is how fast I am, and I practiced, and I practiced over the weeks, and I didn't get much better. And so I said, you know, that's just not going to happen. There's no way I could do that. You know, and when I was in recess in grade school, I was the one that was picked last for two-hand touch football because I couldn't catch the ball. Who am I to think I can catch more balls in a minute than anyone has ever caught before while juggling? You know, there are also thousands of professional jugglers. They do this as their full-time job. I work at Cradle Point, a technology company here in Boise. I've been there 9 years. I have my lunches, evenings, and weekends. I also have 2 kids under 3 years old and a very supportive wife. But after I broke a few Guinness World Records, I bought in. I developed a growth mindset about anything in life. You can improve on anything with no hard upper limit. And so I started practicing for this Guinness World Record, not with the hope that maybe I might break it, but with the belief that I was going to break it. I knew I was. It was just a matter of when was it going to be. Because I practiced every day for a year, and after a year of practice, I got 428 catches in 1 minute, becoming the fastest juggler in the world. Thank you. But it didn't end there. Somebody else broke my record. And so I had to go back with it with a renewed passion and vigor, and now I hold the record for the world's fastest juggling with 556 catches in 1 minute. That's over 9.25 catches per second. And I thought 7 was impossible. 3.5 years ago, if you'd have asked me when I broke my first Guinness World Record, if I could possibly break 10 by today, I would have told you that is a far stretch. But if you asked me today, if I think I could break one Guinness World Record per week, I would tell you yes, with confidence, because I did it last year. And so today, I'm going to attempt to break 3 Guinness World Records live in the next 10 minutes on stage. And so I'm going to welcome up the witnesses and timekeepers who are going to validate this attempt, along with my friend here, Chris Knight. And we are going to attempt to break 3 world records. The first one is a partner record, Chris and I. The record is most ping pong balls caught in 1 minute with chopsticks. When I first practiced this record, I caught 2. The current record is 31. 31 ping pong balls caught with chopsticks in a minute. Now the rules simply state, and Guinness has some very strict rules, they state that you must throw the ping pong ball, catch it cleanly with the chopsticks, and then deposit, it has to bounce once and only once, catch cleanly, and then deposit in a container. We're gonna use an upturned frisbee as our container. Chris and I have 1 world record together already, most frisbee passes in 1 minute at 110. So I've got folks, to validate for Guinness, got 2 people acting as timers, 2 as witnesses. We've got all these videos running, photographic evidence. We'll submit it for approval later. The current record is 31. And remember, the first time we practiced, I got 2. All right, so the timers are going to say ready, set, go, and we will begin the attempt. I'm going to count out loud to give you approximate where I am. If it hits a finger, I'm going to recount that number. So if I say a number twice, you know that I'm just discounting one of the catches. All right. Witness is ready. Timer's ready. Closer. Okay.
Ready, set, go.
82. Nice to hold it back like that, just about that far away. 82 on that one. 83 on that one, but we discounted 1. All right, so that's good. So 1 record down. How are we feeling? This next record combines a couple of different skills I've worked on. One is a lot of weightlifting activities I need to do to juggle bowling balls and axes and balance heavy objects on my chin. And so it combines that strength training with the fast twitch muscles I use for speed juggling. And so for this record, I'm going to attempt the fastest time to pass a 20-pound weight from hand to hand 100 times. So I have a 20-pound kettlebell right there. I'll start with my right hand, and I need it to pass it to my left hand, back to my right hand, left, right, 100 times. The time to beat is 18 seconds. If you do the math, that is over 5 passes per second, times 20 pounds, so 100 pounds of passed weight per second, until I get to 2,000 pounds of passed weight. I'm going to be doing this very fast. It's going to be very difficult to count, so I am going to count every other pass. I'll start with my right hand, I go to my left hand, and when it goes back to my right, I'll say 1, 2, 3, 4, and so forth. I do a little warm-up here, just to give you an idea of what it looks like. Now, I get asked what I'm doing in the gym all the time. What are you training for? Are you like a mountain climber? I say, well, I'm training to pass a kettlebell back and forth between my hands. All right. So for this to work, I've got to weigh it right before and right after the attempt. Got a scale here. We'll put it down. 20-pound kettlebell reads 20 pounds, 9.9 ounces. Walmart, you sold me a 9.9-ounce heavy kettlebell. All right. Uh-oh. It stopped recording. All right, I'm going to have to reweigh it just to make sense. Here we go. Kettlebell, 20 pounds, 9.8 ounces on film. Is anybody in the audience feeling irrationally nervous right now? And you're not even trying to break the record. All right, timer's ready. Witness is ready. Okay.
Ready, set, go.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 20. Oh, I touched it with both hands at the same time. I bet she saw it. Yeah, if two hands touch it at the same time, it disqualifies the attempt. You can't see it in fast motion video, but in slow motion video we would. So I'm gonna have to start back over here. Reweighing it, 20 pounds, 9.7 ounces. Timers and witnesses ready. Now let's go.
Ready, set, go.
One, oh, let's start. Redo, reset, okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 40, 41, 42, 43, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 50. Come on! Woo! Let me look at the stopwatches here. Oh, yes, weigh it. On film, right before and right after, that you're saying weight, 20.9. It looks like we are at 14.9 seconds. Come on! Two down, one to go. All right, so for this last one, I'm like, what can I do to make this 100th Guinness World Record feel special? Like TEDx, TED Talks, it's like a birthday, a milestone, a mark. And so the record I'm gonna attempt to break is for the most candles lit in the mouth. They've gotta be full-sized taper candles. The current record is 41. But it's my 100th Guinness World Record. And so I decided I have to put 100 candles in my mouth. And so what I'm gonna attempt to do now is put 100 candles in my mouth, light them on fire, and then they have to stay there for 30 seconds. Held by nothing but my hands. All right, so here we go. These are what the taper candles look like right here. Get them on film so we can count them individually. We counted them all very carefully before. Eye protection. Mic out of the way. And at this point, I'm gonna be able to stop. Not won't be able to talk anymore. But when we get to, I'm gonna say, when we light all the candles, release my hand, time is gonna start. When I hit 30 seconds, I'm at Guinness World Record number 100. This is not my core competency, but I decided I was gonna do it anyway. Oh. 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 Oh.
Oh. Oh.
That feels good. 100 world records. But remember this. Breaking 100 Guinness World Records was not the end goal. This is simply a tangible example of what you can accomplish if you set your mind to a goal. Believe in yourself and pursue it with a passion. And there are some of you out there that have doubts. You've told yourself something, there's something you can't do, but you'd want to do it anyway. And you wish you could. But you have these doubts. What is that thing? Now go do it. My name is David Rush. Enjoy TEDxBoise.